Macrophages are multitasking cells at the first line of defense against pathogens' invasion. But they can also play a major role in destroying tissues and developing cancer, autoimmune disorder, or allergies. In the traditional nomenclature, M1 macrophages are associated with inflammatory functions and are essential to eliminate pathogens. On the other hand, M2 macrophages have mostly anti-inflammatory functions and are involved in tissue repair. The progressive discovery of multiple functions held by macrophages revealed M1 and M2 as two extremes of a wide spectrum of macrophage subtypes. In response to environmental variations, such as a pathogen presence, a wound, or interactions with immune cells, macrophages can rapidly change its phenotype, resulting in a large range of macrophage subtypes. This variety of phenotypes in vivo needs to be taken into account for in vitro research as well. By using animal-free media containing various stimulating factors, like granulocyte macrophage or macrophage colony stimulating factors, monocytes polarize into M1 or M2 macrophages. To activate these macrophages, specific activators are added to the culture. It can be interleukin, immunoglobulin, or lipopolysaccharide, for example. As a result, a colony is obtained with distinct macrophage subtypes classified by their activation factors. There are already dozens of subtypes identified and can be generated in vitro. Each of them has specific functions. For example, some macrophages neutralize pathogens, while others favor tissue repair. And other functions and mechanisms of macrophages are yet to be discovered, with great application potentials, for example, in cancer therapy. Using a common nomenclature by activation factors provides an experimental standard for making effective progress towards the treatment of many diseases. Learn more about in vitro macrophage generation on PromoCell.com.